Ancient graveyards and cemeteries have proved to be an excellent source of information about the past. Hopefully, this trend holds on larger scales, as astronomers have just discovered a massive necropolis of stars spreading out from the alive and bright spiraled arms of the Milky Way. When we want to learn about the life of someone or something that has long been dead, looking towards their burial place is often a great place to start. Astronomers have found the Milky Way's massive stellar graveyard and hope that studying it will give them more clues about our galaxy's past. When we look up at the sky at night, we can see thousands, if not millions, of stars dotting nearly every inch of the sky. All of these stars are burning their fuel and are, at some point in their lives, between birth and death. We know that stars are born from gas and dust coalescing together, and that when they reach the end of their lives, they can die in brilliant supernovas. But what happens to the mass of the star after it dies? Astronomers have discovered a massive graveyard surrounding the Milky Way, in which an insane number of stellar remnants from the galaxy's spiral arms are flying through interstellar space. Stars begin their journey within massive clouds of dust and gas floating out in space. After enough matter has clumped together to generate a strong enough gravitational force, the star will ignite, and the process of nuclear fusion within its core roars to life. Depending on the size of the star and how much fuel it holds, they can burn for as short of a time as several hundred million years for massive stars that burn hot and bright. While smaller stars like our red dwarf Sun can live for tens, if not hundreds, of billions of years. When stars contain at least 8 times the mass of our Sun, they can explode in a supernova event to form a super dense object. If the star is massive enough, at least 25 times the mass of our Sun, a supernova will lead to the star's core, forming a black hole. These monsters have a gravitational force strong enough to warp the very fabric of space-time, punching a hole in our universe.
Singularity, by definition, right now, is the location where the laws of physics as we currently understand them break down.
For us, the black hole is the end of space, the end of time, the end of everything.
But if the star lacks the mass needed to generate that level of gravitational energy, it won't collapse entirely and instead will form a neutron star. Neutron stars are named such because their gravitational force generated is so powerful that it squeezes electrons and protons together on the subatomic level and forces them to form neutrons. These stars are the densest objects in our universe. Just one teaspoon of its matter will weigh upwards of 4 billion tons. The Milky Way was formed over 13 billion years ago, less than 1 billion years after the Big Bang. In that time, billions of neutron stars have formed and been ejected out into interstellar space, some of them lost to the Milky Way forever. In order to create a map of the Milky Way's underworld, astronomers meticulously recreated the full life cycles of stars going back to the beginning of the galaxy's life. From these recreations, they were able to simulate their path after they were ejected. But this was not like mapping a simple ball flying through the air. The forces from the supernova can cause them to be flung out of their system at speeds reaching millions of kilometers an hour, at nearly unpredictable trajectories. These neutron stars are blasting through space with no friction or air resistance, meaning that they only slow down when influenced by a large gravitational pull, like that of our galaxy. By following their paths, the team was able to find the majority of the neutron stars' final resting places.
The supernova remnant is the result of a massive star blowing up as a supernova when it runs out of fuel in its core. And then the debris gets blown out and keeps expanding into space.
It turns out that an estimated 30% of all neutron stars created in the Milky Way have been ejected from the galaxy's influence entirely, flying through intergalactic space for eternity. One interesting finding in this study showed that, statistically, the closest one of these neutron stars should only be 65 light years away from Earth. That is right in our backyard in galactic terms. Nothing ever sits still in the universe for long, and astronomers had to work hard to reconstruct the movements of these stellar remnants over billions of years. But after painstakingly mapping out the enormous number of neutron stars that have been kicked out of our galaxy by their own supernovas, they create a galactic map that shows a brand new angle of our galaxy. Looking at them side by side, you can see how the graveyard surrounding the Milky Way completely changes its shape, and the Milky Way's characteristic spiral arms completely vanish. Instead, the stellar remnants cause the Milky Way to appear puffed up when viewed from the side. They also determined that some of the neutron stars were kicked out of the galaxy with such force that they broke free of the galaxy's gravitational force altogether and flew free into intergalactic space, gone forever. The supernovas that give birth to neutron stars or black holes are asymmetric explosions, making the paths extremely hard to follow as the remnants are kicked out into interstellar space. These erratic trajectories are responsible for the horde of neutron stars washing out the Milky Way's unique form. It came as quite a shock to the astronomers studying the graveyard, who expected the underworld to be subtly different from the Milky Way, but found a much more radical change in form. They found that the younger, newly formed neutron stars conform much more to the form of today's galaxy, while the ancient neutron stars are still haunting the outer reaches of the graveyard. The galactic underworld actually spans quite a bit larger than the bright star-filled galaxy that we are used to seeing. Neutron stars spread out, forming a puffy halo formation surrounding the galaxy that measures roughly 3 times the height of the Milky Way. Does every galaxy have a graveyard like this? Now that astronomers have developed the methods and technologies to study and map the galactic underworld, there are many plans to go hunting for more and keep improving the understanding of the universe. The mysteries of the universe are slowly beginning to be unraveled and understood. It's only a matter of time until the next big discovery is made in space. Thanks for watching. Leave us a comment down below and let us know what recent space discovery made you go wow. See you next time on Matter.